Good morning, Ananda. Today I'm starting Unit 5. Okay, unit name is Economic Aspects of Power Generation and Tariff. Okay, in this unit, we are having the two topics. First topic is the Economic Aspects of Power Generation and second topic is the Tariff. Okay, first coming to the first topic, that is Economic Aspects of Power Generation. Okay, in the present class, we are discuss about the introduction to economic aspects of power generation and load curves and some definitions that will be related to the economics of power generation. Okay, first of all, what is meant by the why we are going for that economic of power generation, that all will be discussed. Okay, first, what is the definition for that economics of power generation? Okay, the art of determining the per unit cost of production of electrical energy. Okay, we are deciding the per unit cost of electrical energy. Okay, that is the main consideration in the case of a power system. Okay, basically the power system consisting of three parts. Okay, that is generation, transmission and distribution. Okay, first, how much amount of the cost will be spent for that generation of that power and how much amount of the cost will be spent for the distribution of that power and how much amount of cost that will be spent for the transmission of the power. Okay, that all will be considered in the case of a economics of power generation. Based upon that all considerations, okay, we are deciding the cost per unit. Okay, that is the main consideration in the case of a power system. Why? Because means for satisfaction of that consumers and also the distributors, who the power will be distributed to that consumers. Okay, for the satisfaction of both that consumers, okay, we are deciding the perfect cost per unit generation is the major criteria. Okay, that's why, okay, the economics of power generation means the determination of per unit cost. Okay, we're determining the per unit cost is the main consideration. Okay, that is kilowatt hours. Okay, we are deciding the per unit cost per kilowatt hour. Okay, that is all that are the considerations will be considered in the case of the economics of power generation. Okay, understand ma? First of all, what is the main definition for that economic of power generation means? Okay, for determining the per unit cost of production. Okay, for determining the per unit cost of production of electrical energy is known as the economics of power generation. Okay, next, considering economics of power generation while designing and building a power station. Okay, while designing and building a power station, effects should be made to achieve the overall economy so that the per unit cost of production as low as possible. Okay, for the designing and building a power station. Okay, we are constructing the generating stations and the distribution system and the substations. Okay, for considering that the generating stations and the substations, okay, the effect should be made to achieve the overall economy. Okay, that will be affected for achieving the overall economy so that the per unit cost of production as low as possible. Therefore, the per unit cost of the production is as low as possible. Okay, this will be enable the electric supply company to sell the electrical energy at a profit and enjoyable service. Therefore, if the electrical energy is in the profit and ensure that reliable service. Okay, therefore, the system will be in the losses. Therefore, it does not give that reliable of the service. Okay, that's why there will be enable the electric supply company to see the electrical energy at a profit and ensure the reliable of that service. Okay, that is the main consideration for calculation of that economy of that power systems. Okay, that is called as the economics of power generation. Okay, main the basic definition for that economics of power generation is the determining the per unit cost. Okay, we are determining the per unit cost of production of electrical energy. Okay, we are determining the per unit cost of production of electrical energy is known as the economics of power generation. The commonly used definitions are the operations in the economics of power generation is, okay, the commonly used operations and the economics of power generation is, first definition is the connected load. Okay, what is meant by the connected load? Okay, how it will be defined as the connected load? Okay, that means the sum of continuous rating of all the equipments. Okay, we are summing the continuous rating of that all the equipments like bulbs, tubes and fans, electric motors, sockets, outlets and power plugs, etc. are connected to the electrical supply system is known as the connected loads. Okay, it is known as the connected loads. Okay, the sum of continuous rating, suppose, okay, in that room we are using the two fans and the one light or two lights. Okay, in that room the electrical appliances are the two fans and the two lights. Okay, but we are using one fan and the one light in that house or the room. Okay, therefore the connected loads are the one light and the one fan. Okay, therefore, that is the definition of the connected loads. Okay, that is the continuous rating of the equipments. Okay, that connected loads is the sum of continuous rating of all the equipments. Sum of continuous rating of the equipments. That is bulbs, tubes, fans, electric motors and sockets, outlets and power plugs. That are all the connected loads. Okay, understand ma? Next, firm power. Okay, it is defined as the theoretical imaginary value of power. Okay, power is known as the theoretically imaginary value of power. Okay, which a power plant is supposed to produce throughout a year. Okay, therefore that power plant is supposed to produce the throughout year are all at times is known as the firm power. Okay, all at times is known as the firm power. Okay, this is the example of a connected load. Okay, understand ma? This is the example of a connected load. Okay, this is the supply. Okay, this is the supply and this is the tube light, heater, TV, tube light, CLF light and ironing and light fan. Okay, each and every having the different wattage ratings. Okay, each and every having the different wattage ratings. Okay, therefore in that case the connected loads are, okay, in that case the connected loads are all are connected to the supply system and all are in the on condition. All appliances are in the on condition. Okay, therefore the total connected load. Okay, therefore we are calculating the total connected load in the consumer premises is 40 watts. Okay, 1000 watts, 60 watts, 40 watts, 20 watts, 500 watts, 25 watts and 60 watts. Therefore the total connected loads, okay, therefore the total connected loads is 1745 watts. Okay, therefore the total connected loads are the 1745 watts. Okay, understand ma? These are the connected loads. Okay, next demand. Okay, what is meant by the demand? Okay, the demand of installation or the system is the load that draws from the source of a supply. Okay, demand means it is a demand of a installation is the load. Okay, is the load that drawn from the source of supply, that drawn from the source of supply at the receiving terminals. Okay, therefore the average over at a suitable and specified intervals of time. Specified interval of time. Therefore, the demand is expressed in kilowatts or other suitable units. Therefore, it will be expressed in kilowatts. Okay. Therefore, the demand is expressed in the kilowatts. Okay. It is known as the demand. Next, maximum demand and peak load demand and demand factor. Okay. We are having the maximum demands, peak load demands and demand factor. Okay. It is the greatest demand of the load on the power system during a given period is known as the maximum demand. Okay, it is the greatest demand or the highest demand in the power plant or the power system. Okay, then it is called as the maximum demand. Suppose we are using the 60 watts lamp, 100 watts lamp, and also the 1000 watts lamp to the supply. Okay, therefore, in this case, what is the maximum demand? 1000 watts is the maximum demand. Okay, that is the example for that maximum demand. Okay, it is the greatest demand of the load on the power station. Okay, it is the greatest demand of load on the power station during a given period is known as the maximum demand. During a given period is known as the maximum demand. Or it is the maximum load which a consumer uses at any time. Okay, it is a maximum load which a consumer uses at any time. Okay, it can be less than or equal to the connected load. Okay, then it will be less than are equal to the connected load. Okay, connected load means these are all the connected loads. That is 40 watts load, 1000 watts load, 60 watts load, 40 watts, 20, 500 watts, 25 watts, 60 watts. Okay, in this case, the connected loads are 40 plus, 1000 plus, 60 plus, 40 plus, 20 plus, 500 plus, 25 plus, 60. Okay, but the maximum demand in these connected loads are the 1000 watts. Okay, 1000 watts is the maximum demand in this connected load. Okay, next calculate the demand factor. Okay, next we are calculating the demand factor. Okay, what is meant by the demand factor? Okay, it is defined as the ratio of maximum demand to the connected load. Okay, understand ma? It is defined as the ratio of maximum demand to the connected load. Okay, it is the formula for that demand factor. Okay, it is the ratio of maximum demand to the connected load. Okay, it is the ratio of maximum demand to connected load. Okay, we already well understand about the what is meant by maximum demand, what is the connected load. Okay, this is the example for that connected load. So, all the loads will be connected to the supply. Therefore, the connected load is 40 plus 1000 plus 60 plus 40 plus 20 plus 500 plus 25 plus 60. Therefore, the connected loads is 1745 watts. Therefore, the connected load is 1745 watts. Okay, in this case, the maximum demand is 1000. Therefore, the demand factor. Okay, how we will calculate that demand factor? Therefore, demand factor, that is D dot F. Demand factor means D dot F. Okay, what is the formula for demand factor? That is maximum demand by connected load. Okay, what is the maximum demand in these loads? That is 1000 watts. Okay, what is the maximum demand? That is 1000 watts. Okay, therefore 1000 by what is the connected loads? That is 1745 watts is the connected loads. Okay, this is the demand factor. Okay, this is the value for the demand factor for these loads. Okay, this is the value for the demand factor for these loads. In this case, demand factor is equal to maximum demand by connected load. Okay, in these loads, what is the demand factor? 1000 watts is the demand factor. And what is the connected loads? That is 1745 is the connected loads. Okay, 1745 is the connected loads. Okay, this is the value for the this connected loads demand factor. Next, coming to the load curve. Okay, next coming to the load curve. Okay, what is the definition for that load curve? Okay, first of all, definition. Okay, what is the definition for that load curve? The load curve is the graph which represents the load on the generating station. Okay, it is a graph that will be represented, which represents the loads. Okay, at particular time, what is the loads that will be connected? That all will be observed by using this load curves. Okay, that all will be observed by using this load curves. Okay, it is a curve or a graph which represents the loads on a generating station. Okay, therefore, the loads are in kilowatts or megawatts. Okay, the loads are in kilowatts or the megawatts. Okay, recorded at the intervals of half hour or the hour against the time. Okay, therefore, the load curve is defined. Therefore, the load curve is defined as the curve which is drawn between the loads versus time. Okay, therefore, the graph is drawn between the loads in kilowatts versus time with respect to the time in sequential order. Okay, we have to draw the load curve on daily basis data, weekly basis data, or monthly basis data. Okay, the curve shows the variations of the load on the power station, which represents to the time, is known as the load curve. Okay, this load curve represents the, or it shows the variations of the load on the power station. Variations of the load on the power station with respect to the time. Variations of the load on the power station with respect to the time is known as the load curve. With respect to the time is known as the load curve. Okay, this is the definition for that load curve. This load curve we will draw on the basis of the daily, monthly, and weekly. Okay, this load curve is drawn on the basis of the daily, weekly, and the monthly. Okay, this is the load curve system diagram. Okay, this is the graph that will be shown. Okay, this is the graph that will be shown in between the load in megawatts and the time in hours. Okay, this is the time in the hours. Okay, we are considering that is 12 midnight to 12. 12 midnight to 12. Okay, then this is the load in the megawatts, or we are taking that loads in the kilowatts also. Okay, this is the graph that will be shown the loads variations with respect to the time. Okay, with respect to the time it will be observed. Okay, therefore, and the x-axis we are taking, that is the time in hours, and y-axis we are taking the load power in megawatts are the kilowatts, are the loads in megawatts are the kilowatts. Suppose at the midnight we are using 1 kilowatt, and at 12 a.m. we are using the 1 kilowatt, and 4 a.m. we are using 2 kilowatts, and 6 a.m. we are using 4 kilowatts, 8 a.m. we are using the 4 kilowatts, and also At 10 a.m., we are using the 2.25 kilowatt megawatts. Okay, therefore, by observing this graph, what is the maximum demand or the maximum load? Okay, this is the maximum load. Okay, that is 6 megawatts. Okay, this is the maximum load. That is the 6 megawatts at a time of 6 p.m. Okay, this is the maximum load or the maximum demand. Maximum load or the maximum demand at a time of 6 p.m. At a time of 6 p.m. Therefore, each and every time, how much amount of loads will be connected or that wall will be observed by using these load curves. Okay, by using these load curves. Next, the load curve gives the what is the information that will be obtained by using that load curve. Okay, the daily load curve shows the variations of the load on the station during the different hours of a day. Okay, this is the daily load curve. Okay, why? Because it will be called as the daily load curve. Okay, therefore, the time will be considered in the hours. Okay, then this load curve is called as the daily load curve. The daily load curve shows the variations of the load on the power station. Okay, variations of the load on the power station during different hours of the day. Okay, during different hours of the day. Next, the area under the daily load curve gives the number of units generated in a day. Okay, therefore, unit generated per day is equal to area under the daily load curve. Units generated per day is equal to the area under the daily load curve. Okay, therefore, the area under the daily load curve gives the number of units generated in a day. Okay, it gives the number of units generated in a day. Therefore, the number of units generated per day is equal to area under the daily load curve. Okay, therefore, the units generated per day is equal to area under the daily load curve. Okay, therefore, the highest point on the daily load curve represents the maximum demand. Okay, this is the highest point on the daily load curve. Okay, this curve is known as the daily load curve. Okay, in this curve, okay, the highest point or the peak point is the 6 megawatts is the peak point. Okay, that is called as the maximum demand. Okay, maximum demand on that day. Okay, that is called as the maximum demand on that day. Okay, therefore, average load. Okay, what is the formula for average load? Therefore, average load is equal to area under the daily load curve by hours in a day. Okay, area under the daily load curve. Okay, what is the area? This is the area that will be under the daily load curve by hours in a day. Okay, what is the hours in a day? That is 24 hours. That is 24 hours. Therefore, average load is equal to area under the daily load curve by 24 hours. Okay, that is the load curve. Okay, the load curve is mainly three criteria are the three types of load curves are there. That is the daily load curve. Okay, this is the daily load curve. Okay, and monthly load curve. Daily load curve and monthly load curve and yearly load curve. okay, these are the different types of the load curves that will be represented in the graph. Okay, understand ma? Okay, this is the daily load curve. Why? How we will be identified? This is the daily load curve means in that the time will be taken in the hours in a day. Okay, similarly we draw the monthly load curve and yearly load curve. Okay, similarly we will draw the monthly load curve and yearly load curve. Okay, first we are drawing the monthly load curve. Monthly load curve. Okay, how many days are there in a month? That is 30 or 31st. Okay, therefore we are considering first day, second day, and so on up to 30th day. Up to 30th day. And this is the loading kilowatts or the megawatts. This is the load in kilowatts or the megawatts. Okay. At this particular day, that is 30th day, okay, we are obtaining the maximum demand or the highest peak demand. Okay, understand ma? At this particular time or the particular day, we are obtaining the maximum demand or the highest peak demand. Okay, this load is called as the maximum demand. Okay, that will be obtained at a particular load. Okay, this type of graph representation is called as the monthly load curve. Okay, this is the monthly load curve. Okay, we are representing in the particular month days. Okay, with respect to the load in kilowatts or the megawatts. Okay, similarly, we are draw the yearly load curve. Okay, how many months are there? We are having 12 months. Okay, this is first month, second month, third month, fourth month, up to 12th month. And we are considering that is the loads in kilowatts are the megawatts. Okay, these are the loads in the kilowatts are the megawatts. Okay, therefore, we are representing the at month one, how much amount of the loads will be obtained? Up to 12th month. Okay, this is the maximum demand or the maximum load at this particular month. At this particular month, we are obtaining the maximum load. Okay, this type of load curve is called as the yearly load curve. Okay, this type of load curve is called as the yearly yearly load curve. And this is the daily load curve, and this is the monthly load curve, and this is the yearly load curve. Okay, on the basis of the time, we are defined as that daily load curve, monthly load curve, and yearly load curves. Okay, understand ma? These are the some definitions that will be related to the economics of power generation. That is the demand. What is meant by demand? And what is meant by the maximum demand? And what is meant by the demand factor? And what is meant by the connected load? Okay, that all will be discussed. Okay, first we are calculating the demand factor. Is that it is the ratio of maximum demand to the connected load. Okay, next we are calculating that load factor, load curve. Okay, the graph that will be drawn in between the load in kilowatts versus with respect to the time. Okay, then this type of graphical representation is called as the load curves. Okay, thus load curves are divided into three criteria based upon that time. Okay, that is daily load curve, monthly load curve, and yearly load curves. Okay, these are the representation for the daily load curve, monthly load curve, and yearly load curve. Okay, therefore, that load curve gives the information about the area under the daily load curve. Okay, therefore, the units generated. Okay, it gives the information about the how much amount of units that will be generated. Okay, that is the area under the daily load curve. How we will be identify that number of units generated means the area under the daily load curve. Okay, what is the area under the daily load curve? Okay, this is the area that under that daily load curve. Okay, therefore, average load is equal to area under the daily load curve by hours. Okay, therefore, average load is equal to area under the daily load by curve by hours in a day. How many hours are there? That is 24 hours in a day. Okay, therefore, highest point on that daily load curve is called as the maximum demand. Okay, understand ma? This happens.